All right, hello everyone. Happy Tuesday, May 11th. We're here for all my intro psych folks for our last Twitch stream. I see a lot of you putting your names in the chat, which is fantastic. Let me know, can you hear and see me okay before we keep going? Someone let me know if everything is coming through clearly. I love that. Dinosaur. Great. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Savannah. Perfect. All right. Thank you all. Thank you for letting me know. Hard to believe, but we are very close now to the end of the semester. I'm glad all of you are here with me for our last stream here. We'll go over some of the things that are going on for this week, the things that you have due. I have a couple of quick comments about last week, and then we'll wrap it up. Yeah, me too. You know, it's the end of the semester is always a little bit bittersweet, especially for summer, right? There's an excitement that we're hitting summertime, but then there's a sadness that it's done. So hard to believe that it feels like it went really quickly. And at the same time, January feels like a very long time ago. So kind of a strange semester, an even stranger year. It sounds like things will be a little more normal in the fall. And hopefully we can all kind of go on a few summer trips and have a little bit more of a summer than we did last year. I know we have a couple of trips planned to go camping and go a couple of places. So I'm looking forward to summer, even if it is sad that our class is nearing an end. So either way, thank you again for being here. I'm gonna put this reminder in the chat one last time. I really appreciate, just as a side note, all of you who took the time to do this all semester long. I know it's an extra step, but it really saves me a lot of time from not having to download the list and like go through and match your names. So thank you for all of you who made sure you kept your little icon all the way through. If you've lost it, you could do it one last time for today's stream. But thank you again. I appreciate the help with making that a little easier on me. But don't forget to check that. And then I want to put in here just as a reminder, and I'm sure I'll mention it several times, but our class officially, wow, I can't type in right. Officially ends on Sunday, May 16th at 11:59 p.m. And I just want to stress that, because once the class has officially ended, it's really difficult for me to give you any kind of extension this week. So just please make sure you're getting everything in on time. I know emergencies come up, but final grades are due very quickly once the class has ended. So just make sure that you're very aware of the time. Try and do things a little bit early, if at all possible, just to avoid those last minute issues. It's always the case when you wait till the very end that something goes wrong. So just try and be on top of it this week. We do have a couple of things that we have due. I'll give you one last Twitch extra credit question, and we will go through it. So let's head over to Canvas together. So again, if we scroll all the way down, our to-do list here is getting shorter and shorter by the week. But all the way down, we are in week number 17. So just a few quick thoughts from last week. Last week we were looking at social psychology. A lot of you writing great accounts of some of the random acts of kindness that you did. A few of you kind of sticking to family or people you live with to make it a little easier. But I enjoyed reading those. Hard to read about all of your examples of prejudice and discrimination. You know, almost all of us have been a victim of one of those things at some point, which can be obviously very uncomfortable. And so hopefully those strategies that you focused on for how to eliminate prejudice and discrimination, or how to reduce them, will go a long way for you. And as I shared with you in the lecture for last week, I had such a cool piece of advice from my instructor in graduate school to just take a random class here or there, or maybe do a random event, or go to a random something or other that you would never go to. You never know what you might get out of it, and it might just broaden your horizons enough, you know, to kind of change your worldview a little bit. So I hope that you take that advice if you ever have the opportunity. I totally thought that it would be impossible, and it was such a fun suggestion. So I hope if you have the time one day, even if it's not right now, take a random class that you wouldn't normally take, or go to a random event or gathering that you wouldn't normally go to, and just see what you get out of it. So anyway, as we leave last week behind, again, the biggest reason that people lost points was just not giving me enough detail or not responding to a peer. But the vast majority of you at this point, I think, have a really great idea of what I'm looking for at this point, and did a wonderful job. So let's talk about this week number 17. And look, there's nothing under it, right? So I get sentimental toward the end. I'll say last and final way too many times tonight. But as we get into this last week, you have your closing assignment, which I'll go over again for you. And then you have the final exam number 4, and the Twitch extra credit for this week. So three kind of main components. There's also one more thing that I would like to ask to remind you to do. So I'll get to that in a couple of minutes. But let's go through these things, and if you have any questions, please feel free to put it in the chat, and I would be happy to answer it for you. But the closing assignment is the first thing that you have for this week, and this is my way of having you think back over the semester without making your final cumulative. So, my way of kind of making you reflect a little bit on all of the things that we've learned. So, if you click on the instructions, what you'll be doing for this is you'll be thinking of five specific ways that the content from this course can apply to your life. Now, this is a really big program goal for psychology, that we want you to be able to apply the materials to your life in some way. And so I'm kind of encouraging you to think about how you could take some of the things you've learned and apply them to your life. So I'll get to your question here in one second. Hopefully I'll answer it for you actually here in just a sec. So you're coming up with five specific concepts or terms that we've covered. And I made a list for you, which I'll show you in a minute, but it can be anything, right? So it can be any topic that we have covered throughout the course of the semester. So yeah, it could be any of the things. You wrote personal situation theory or compromise, that's fine. Rather than picking like learning, like a big concept, pick a specific topic. So rather than learning, pick positive reinforcement. Or rather than stress, you would pick compromise, right? That's totally fine. But you're picking five different concepts or terms, either from that list, or it can be beyond that. That's totally fine. And then you're gonna follow this very specific format of you're gonna give me the term. You'll tell me if you found the term in either the lecture or the textbook. You'll define it, which can be copied and pasted. That can be verbatim. That's totally fine. And then you're gonna give me about a paragraph telling me how you can use that information that you've learned to help you in a real life situation in the future. Maybe you could also mention something that you did in the past, but now you understand it a little bit differently. You're gonna take that concept and apply it. And I'll show you an example of this in just a moment. As far as formatting goes, it's not necessarily a paper. In a way, it's more of like five separate ideas, so you don't have to have transitions and opening and closing paragraphs. You're literally going to number them 1 through 5 and follow this format here. And then you'll write as clearly as possible. It should be roughly 2 pages or so in general, with standard margins and fonts. And you'll submit it right here through this link. So right here at the top, you'll hit Start Assignment, and you can attach it as a file. You are limited to these ones right here, so Doc, DocX, PDF, and a rich text format. But any of those would be fine. Yes, anything from the textbook or the lectures. So any concept from the book or lecture that we've covered at some point this semester is totally fine. So think about the things that we've covered, and if any of them maybe resonated with you. Maybe when we talked about memory, you were like, oh, mnemonic devices, those are great. That's something I can use. Or I mentioned positive reinforcement. Maybe it was remembering your dreams, and the tips on how to remember dreams were something that stuck with you. So just think about five different things that you can take away. And I made that concept list to help you, but you can definitely go outside of it if you have something else you want to do. So I'll show you an example in a moment, but while we're here, a few other things. You'll submit it right here. I gave you a rubric so you could see how I'm grading you. It's worth 25 points, so basically 5 points for each one of the concepts that you do. And I will be grading them. I'm trying to grade them as they come in, but I'll definitely be grading them once the deadline has passed. So here are the instructions, but if you go back one page and you go to our week here, so you have the instructions, and then here's the concept list. So as I mentioned, I was just trying to give you a place to start in case you were overwhelmed by the amount of material. So for example, this was a chapter, and here are some of the main terms or concepts in that chapter. The consciousness unit, here are some of the main ideas, but you can literally pick anything from the book or the lecture, anything that jumps out at you. But I tried to give you a place to start just so that you weren't maybe trying to come up with it out of nowhere. So there's the concept list. And then right underneath it, I gave you a sample paper just so you could see how this is formatted. And ideally, you can stay pretty close to this formatting. Just it makes it really simple for me to see what you're doing. And again, it's not so much of a paper as much as you're just following this style. So for example, this person did egocentrism, and it was from the lecture. They defined it and then wrote a paragraph about how to apply it. Now, that's not necessarily a topic that we got too much into. This one is, though, negative reinforcement, which was from the textbook. They gave an ex definition and then a paragraph describing how they could use that in some way in their life. Fundamental attribution error from the lecture. Here's the definition, and then a paragraph of how you could use it and apply it in your life. And then I wrote, and so on. So you'll do this 5 times for 5 different terms, and it's worth 25 points. So I hope that helps this. I just wanted to give you a sample so you could kind of see what I was looking for. But try and follow this format. It doesn't need to be like a full-blown paper. It's more 5 separate terms. I'm really focusing on how you connect it to being able to apply it to your life in some way. That's the biggest thing that I want. It can be single or double spaced. Either one is fine. I'm not going to worry too much about the spacing and formatting, as long as the content is there for this. That's really all I'm looking for. So it can be either single or double. Either one is totally fine. Double space is definitely the APA style, but this isn't a research or academic empirical paper, so it's totally fine if you want to do single spaced. Are there any other questions about the closing assignment? Sure, no problem. Uncharted Dragon, I love it. All right, so here's the closing assignment again. Here are the instructions, the concept list, which you may go beyond if you have a different idea, and then the sample submission, just so that you can see what this might look like. And then we'll say any other questions at all about the closing assignment? I had somebody ask me by email today. They said I have an A in the class and I've calculated my grade based on my points. Whether I do the assignment or not, I will still have an A or still have a B. The class is completely based off of points, so you can decide whether to do this or not depending on if it will help or hurt your grade. That's definitely your right to decide. So if you have a very strong A and losing 25 points won't hurt you, that's completely within your realm to decide. But I do think it's a wonderful way to think back over the semester without having to take a cumulative test. So I don't see any other questions at the moment, so I'm going to keep going. But if you think of something, feel free to put it in the chat. The other really big thing that we have this week is you do have exam number 4. Now, the final exam or exam number 4 is just a fourth test. So it is just on this last unit, these last 4 chapters. It's not cumulative, it's the same format and style as the tests you've taken all semester. If you click on the study guide and let that open up, you'll see that it's on chapters 13, 14, 15, and 16. So just like with the other three exams that you've taken in here, if it's on the study guide, it will be on the test. So make sure that you know all of these terms related to stress and health, all of these related to mental illness and the psychological disorders, everything here for chapter 15 on the therapies, and then all of these terms for chapter 16 on social psychology. So if it's not on here, you can let it go. You don't have to study it. But if it is on here, make sure you understand it well enough that you can answer some questions about it. Remember, you don't want to be trying to understand the term as soon as you are trying to answer the question. If you do that, it's going to end up taking up quite a bit of your time. Generalized anxiety disorder is not mentioned in the, it should be mentioned in there somewhere. I will go back and check, but if you have another, if you think of any other ones that you don't think were mentioned, let me know and I'll go see if I can find them. Though I thought that one was in either the lecture or the book, but if you have any other ones, please feel free to tell me. So again, the study guide is your friend when preparing for the exam. Make sure that you know everything on here. At this point, you should be pretty comfortable with the exam format. The exams are on the ebook page, so you can get there by clicking on the exam number 4 link, if I go back here. So you can click on the link right here and it will remind you to go to the ebook page, and there's a link here as well. Or you can just go sign in. Hopefully you have it bookmarked by now. And then up here at the top, you'll hit exams. And then there's all the same reminders that you've had all semester long. So you have 75 minutes, you get one attempt, so be ready and organized before you begin. Make sure you have good internet connection and that you have a quiet place to take it. You can use your notes and your book, but again, you'll run out of time if you're trying to look everything up. So try to go through and prepare and study. Again, if it were me, I would write everything out and have it in front of me, but I tend to over-prepare. So totally up to you. A lot of you have done really well on the exam so far. So keep preparing the same way and you hopefully will be in good shape. So when you're done, don't forget to save your answers and you'll have a score instantly. I will be bringing the exam scores over to Canvas once the deadline has passed. So once we make it through the rest of the week, I will bring all those scores over. So don't worry if it's not in Canvas right away. But here is the exam. That's the other really big thing for this week. I also want to mention, I talked about this last week, I believe. If you click on the quizzes tab, remember that there's this little SLO question that I asked all of you to complete. So this is not worth any points, but the psychology department is trying to gather some data. So please take a moment. You could even do it now with me if you want. It's one question. If you click on it, this should be very, very simple. But if you hit start or resume survey, it's psychology is a science, true or false. This should be a very easy question, but hopefully you can all find a chance to take this. We do need that data, so that would be really helpful if you could go through and take this at some point this week. It should only take you like 20 seconds, but it would be very helpful for the department to have that data from you. So if you click on quizzes, again, that's where you would find it. It's just this little SLO question, student learning outcome question that I need all of you to answer. So if you haven't done that yet, please go back and answer it. That would be really helpful. Someone asked, are we still going to have access to your book after the class is over? Found some things very interesting, would like to go back and review. So I'm pretty sure that you have access for, I believe it's 6 months or something like that for the ebook. But there are some deadlines for accessing all of the materials. So I believe that it's 6 months that you have access to the ebook. So what you might want to do is download or print anything that you really wanted to be able to access in the long term, so that you don't lose that once that time has passed. Okay. All right. Are there any other questions, thoughts, comments, anything else about the other required stuff for this week, I have one more thing I want to remind you about before I give you the Twitch extra credit question. But any other questions or thoughts or comments or anything? While I'm waiting for that, let me give you the other thing that I wanted to remind you. I mentioned this as well before, but please take a moment sometime this week to click on the grades tab and take a look at your grades. And I pulled this up before, it's so shameful. 0 points. I'm not only failing, I have a perfect zero. But take a minute to look over your scores. And if something is missing that shouldn't be, or if one of your scores is wrong, for some reason I didn't bring a test score over, or it's reversed, or it's just missing, whatever the case might be, if anything looks wrong, please reach out to me in the next few days so that we can look into it and fix it. Once the class ends and I do final grades, it's very difficult to change your grade. It's not impossible, but it requires signatures and all sorts of stuff. So if you notice that something is wrong, it would be wonderful if we could address it now. So just if anything looks incorrect, send me a quick email and we can look at it together. So just sometime this week, look over your scores. You can also see your total points and how that stacks up with the syllabus, and see what you maybe need to get on the final in order to get the grade that you want. But just take a quick look at your grades and let me know if for some reason anything looks incorrect. Otherwise, let me give you the Twitch extra credit question. As we get toward the end here, kind of an easy question, having you think back over the semester. There we go. Okay, put it in the chat. So the extra credit question is, I would like you to think about the class and give me one specific thing that you enjoyed about the way the class was taught or structured, or how the lectures were delivered, and then give me one specific thing that you would change to make it better. And please feel free to be honest. It's nice to have the feedback. Specifically, I would love your thoughts on, you know, did you like the lectures being recorded versus when we were doing them live together at the beginning? Were the Twitch sessions helpful? But it could be anything. One specific thing that you liked and one thing that you would change to maybe make it a little bit better. So I'm going to put that here in the chat. And when you're ready to answer that, you'll go to Canvas and you'll go all the way down to week number 17 and you'll click right here on Twitch Extra Credit 17. And then start assignment up here at the top. And then you can type your response right here. Oops. And go ahead and hit submit. So you can do that anytime before Sunday night at 11:59 p.m. To get those last 2 points of extra credit. And you're welcome to do that, you know, just to respond on here like that. And other than that, I think those are all of the things that I wanted to review with you. Don't forget about the closing assignment, the exam, the extra credit. Check your grades, do that SLO question, that really quick true or false question. And more than anything, thank you all again for joining me, you know, every Tuesday night on here, or watching this later if your schedule didn't allow. And thank you for a really wonderful semester in class. I know normally we'd be meeting in person and it's been really different, but thank you all for sharing in this time with me. And I hope you have a wonderful summer and you stay safe and take care of yourselves. And hopefully the fall will be much more normal than this spring was. So yes, same, right? It's always sad to see things end, but at the same time, summer is very exciting. So we'll be happy about that. But thank you all. Thank you. I get sentimental at the end here. So what I'll do, I'm going to minimize my video here in just a moment, but I will hang out for a little bit if you have any questions or comments or anything. But again, thank you all. Aww, thank you too. So if you think of anything after we're done today, of course, feel free to email me. I do teach abnormal psychology, research methods, human sexuality, and personality theories. If you wanted to take another psychology class. Those are all ones that I teach, and they're all going to be online in the fall. So you can take a look at any of those, abnormal psych or human sexuality or research methods. I'm teaching all of those in the fall, so you're welcome to join me if you would like more. Otherwise, have a wonderful summer. Thank you all as well for a great semester. I'm going to minimize my video, but I will hang out a little bit. Thank you too. I love that. One crying and the other looks really happy. Potato King. I think my favorite part about Twitch is all of the usernames. They're so funny. I love it. I want to change mine to something funny. Thank you as well.